volunteers for bus number 833. Please have your passes and tickets ready.
Good morning. Good morning to you. Oh, hello. Tom, my name is Jezebel. But don't get any ideas. Oh, I have been on a lot of buses in my time, but this one is my favorite bus ever.
Well, that is great to hear. Welcome aboard.
I could say the same to you. You can't buy four.
No, they're only said.
Never. Not three. It has to be three or five.
I was just saying that.
Not four, not eight.
Yes, Mother.
Never.
But
never four of anything. There shouldn't even be a number four. Even numbers are just so. Well, I can't even say it.
What about socks? You have to buy four socks.
Socks is a pair. You get three pairs. It's a pair of pairs. Rita.
Either.
Either. You get five pairs, seven pairs. They're like units, like eyeglasses or pants. You don't buy one pant. She thinks you can buy one pant.
All I said was I need new chairs. The fourth side of the table for? The butler?
There are four chairs and a table. Five, it's a set. Buy the set.
I don't need a set. I need chairs.
You are ignoring the whole paradigm of balance and polarity, Susan. It is very feng shui-lap.
Ish.
Ish. Sway-ish. Call me crazy, but the universe depends on us for order and balance, Susan. Oh, as I told that great 1960s philosopher, Grace Slick, you are the crown of creation, Susan, and you've got no place to go.
And if she did, she wouldn't. Believe me, I have tried.
Is that the way you talk to your mother?
Yes, obviously it is. Why do I ask? Didn't we just go shopping?
I wish you were something besides black all the time. It makes you look dusty.
Dusty is good. I'll blend in with my friends, the dusty street people.
I forbid you to become street people. Person. God, I say one word about your appearance and you go home nuts.
Sorry, Mother, no offense.
None taken, dear.
And we don't have any of that kind of thing where we live.
Oh, yes, we do, dear. Over on Elm. Oh, lovely folks. Oh, Francis the Cat, Mrs. Two Teeth, Long Tall Wallet. You need to get out more. Leave the house once in a while and learn to ignore what people say about you behind your back. Now me, I love our outings. Sundays would not be the same without our monthly bus ride to the house. Here, I got these for you for the trip. They're olives. You like olives. I've seen you eat them. There's 27.
27 olives. I can understand getting a dozen or a handful. How do you even buy 27 olives? It's ridiculous.
They're good olives, and they're for you. I got them for you.
I didn't say they weren't good.
You like olives. You should eat them.
Maybe later. Thank you.
Fine. Don't. You won't have to put up with me and my stupid olives for very long. You'll be happy when I'm gone. You'll see.
Keep saying that, but you never actually give us a date.
I swear, young lady.
Oh, lovely Rita, my
favorite.
Only granddaughter. Lovely Rita, Rita May. Nothing could be.
Something. Not my hair's time, stick of olives.
Oh, you smell like the Greek princess. When are you free to take some tea with me? Oh, we're making great time. And look, there's the turnaround where they switch drivers. Just time enough to stretch our legs, and then we can see the house. Come on, girls, fresh air awaits. Londiamo!
I don't know what's worse, the ride or the climbing up and down these stairs. I bet those handrails have never been cleaned. Whose idea was this anyway?
It's hers, of course. It's what makes us family.
I demand a DNA test. Do you want your jacket? There's a jacket in the back. I don't even look like her.
A little late to think about that.
I've been hearing about these reading clubs. Maybe we should start one. Well, reading clubs, book clubs, whatever they call it. We all pick a book, read it, and then we just talk about it. It is another brilliant idea. Oh, we should start with On the Road, because we are
on the road. Well, a road. I mean, this is a road, isn't it? Allen Ginsberg told me that Kerouac, Susan, Jack Kerouac, he wrote this book, On the Road. He was a Canadian, a football player, lumberjack, something like that.
I know who Kerouac is.
Allen Ginsberg told me that Kerouac wrote the entire manuscript of On the Road on the backs of cereal boxes. But Ginsberg was on drugs at the time, so... And I didn't think cereal came in boxes back then. I remember cereal in cellophane bags. I remember cellophane bags. Rita, pick a book.
I'm reading a post-cyberpunk apocalypse, so writing is just a way of denying the unavoidable pointlessness of the universe as it slips into the meaningless void of Jean-Paul Sartre meets the screamo kind of Japanese cell phone short story blog thing. A writing that will spill out the futility of life in 280 character chunks and then disappear, yet leave every word burned into my tortured breast.
Well, no wonder it's tortured, sweetheart. I mean, look at the poor dears. We need to get you a better fitting bra.
Grant, you!
Susan, what's your book, Susan? Come on, pick a book, any book. Now, don't show it to me. Are you paying attention, Susan?
Constantly, Mother. Oh, I think I have a fever. Rita, feel my head. Do I have a fever?
Feel your own head. What is with this family in heads?
Do I see a drugstore back there? Someone needs to remind me to pick up aspirin on the way home.
Aspirin will kill you, dear. Oh, look, oregano. I've never seen magnetic oregano before.
You just had magnetic nutmeg over here. Is that the spices I know the names of but can never imagine using box?
I don't mean aspirin. I mean that stuff you take instead of aspirin.
Arsenic.
Boeth and pre-chewed willow bark from the mountains of Nicaragua.
That's ridiculous, Mother. I need something that works. I've been having these waves of hotness.
When was this, 1980?
There's nothing you can't take. What's Ethel Merman doing in my head? Boiled and pre-chewed willow bark has worked for the indigenous Miskito peoples of Central America for hundreds of years, Susan. Oh, that is a very colonistic attitude to take about your premenstrual hot flashes, and I, for one, take offense.
Oh, because of your well-known Central American ancestry. Don't be ridiculous. I am only around 35.
That is three times you have called me ridiculous in under 10 minutes. Well, if I didn't know better, I would think you meant it personally.
Perspicacious. Perspicacious. It was on the bus over there. I've never seen a magnetic word that long. What kind of box is this?
Aren't magnets fun? You know, I think it may take all three of us actually having fun together to completely and properly express how much fun we are having. Susan!
Oh. When did I get stuck in a game of telephone?
The what, dear?
The game. The telephone game. I say a word. You say what you think you've heard, except you're wrong. You pass it around anyway. And nobody pays any attention to what it was I was actually trying to say. Everybody thinks it's hysterical. Unless, in fact, you are the one trying to say something. You know, my life.
Is it like charades?
You don't talk in charades.
Maybe that's what she meant.
That's not what I meant! Jesus!
Well, let's not get all pissy, Susan. I merely suggested we read a book, and only you can find something wrong with reading a book. I swear, I have seen you reading books. Oh, are you reading filth, Susan? An embarrassing piece of trash. Some soft covers, seedy, smut. By a Republican.
Well, you can tell us. We won't judge. I mean, we are practically family.
We had a cousin once. I think on the O'Dooley side. Well, his uncle invented the typewriter ribbon. And they had this service where if you made a mistake typing, you could just bring the page to them, and then they would scrape the words off the paper with a very sharp little special silver knife. Very environmentally ahead of themselves, don't you know, because you could use it all over again. Oh, they made a fortune. Until my Naismith's mother. You know. From the Muckies. The band. From the 60s. Oh, the Muckies on TV. Take the last train to somewhere. Well, she, Betty, the Muckies' mother. Well, Mike was the Muckie, not the mother. She invented that liquid paper stuff, and then our cousins just went all bankrupt. Well, I think it's a very interesting story. Oh, prolix. Whatever could that mean?
That's it! If I have to hear another story from Mother Goose over here about something that never actually happened, I am going to scream. Ah! Nobody said anything. I was practicing. If I told a psychiatrist about this family, she'd take me away for my own protection. God, I wish she would. We've been riding this stupid bus since I was, I don't know, 5. And one day we're gonna slow down at the train tracks and that damn house will be demolished. And I'll be the happiest person in the whole fucking world.
You want some action, Dracula?
come on, cause it's go time!
It is not go time! We don't do go time! Will you both please settle down?
You think I won't just because I was at Woodstock? Well, I knocked out Joni Mitchell behind the first date champ with one punch, and she was Stardust and Golden, damn it!
You were never at Woodstock, Mother! And there was some woman who looked vaguely like, you know, the blonde woman from Peter, Paul, and Mary. You backed into her car in a parking lot in Encino, and then you drove away!
And don't you forget it!
I don't see her. She's probably halfway home by now. She's run away with a biker gang. That would be a horrible situation. They have no idea what they're in for. I hope they have insurance. Certainly a spirited child, isn't she? Takes after you, I guess. You know what they say? Things skip a generation. Musical abilities. Blue eyes. Lunacy. God, I'm tired. I shouldn't be this tired. Did you ever see that stuff you spray in the shower? No, the stuff that cleans pennies. I saw it once on TV. I don't know if it's some nasty chemical solution or just lemon juice. I wasn't paying that much attention. You take a dish of this liquid and you dip an old corroded penny in it. And it comes out sparkling clean. Old and worthless. Dip right in there. Just like that. Everyone still has pennies, of course. That's what I'd like. Something you could dip me into, and I'll come out a bright new copper penny. My hair shiny, my skin all the same color instead of this crazy quilt. No sandpaper on every sticky outy part. I could get up out of a chair without making that noise. I'm not even 40 yet. And I'm already making that groaning noise. I don't realize it half the time. God, doesn't matter what it costs. Be cheaper than what I put myself through now. Sag-proof underwire underwear, whatever the hell this thing is called. It's holding my internal organs in place. Face cream, foot cream, eye cream, butt cream, the Zumba, the orthopedic running shoes, the orthopedic walking shoes, the horse pill vitamins that make me pee like one, the tooth cleaning, face scrubbing, lip waxing, just one dip. Cheap at twice the price.
kind of enjoy making that noise. Oh, you just want to be young again.
I didn't want to be young in the first place. I hated being young. I honestly don't know how Rita does it. Remember that time in high school I ironed my hair? Jeanette Vasquez, because she was the most popular girl in our class. This gorgeous, long, straight black hair. I just knew that if I had hair like hers, I would be popular too. I swear, in the middle of the night, I can still smell it burning.
I had a haircut once. I hated it so much, I shaved my head so I could start over.
What happened?
Well, after 6 months, it was worse than when I started. I had dyed my hair so many colors, blue, purple, platinum once, because I was reading Lord of the Rings for the 20th time.
Yeah.
I forgot what color my hair really was. I dyed it so much. This big mass of horrible, dull, boring hair just lying there on my head. It was horrible.
I don't know what's going on with her. We used to be able to talk about anything, and now I can barely remember what her voice sounds like.
She is going through a phase.
Phase? What phrase?
A phase. She is a teenager.
Well, I was a teenager.
And you were no promenade along the saying either.
Maybe she needs a hobby, some sort of after-school activity.
She has one. She's a cynic. It'll probably turn into a full-time career.
How about music? I loved music when I was her age. Has she ever talked about playing an instrument?
Since when do you love music?
I used to keep a radio under my pillow. It whispered in my ear late into the night. After midnight or so, when the local stations go off and the air is still, you can pick up Chicago or California. Once in a great while, WQXR in New York. They played whole symphonies. The most glorious opera music I've ever heard.
This is the first I've heard of this. Your father loved music.
Yes, I know. I better go try to find Rita before Bus pulls out that something else she can blame on me.
See how they curl around each other? So happy! A friendly, kittenish harmony of nature. The nautilus shell arrangement. The serene, seductive innocence. 27! 2 and 7 is 9. 27, 3 times 9,
27, the atomic number of cobalt, the main component of B12. 3 and 9 is 12. 1 and 2 is 3. 9 divided by 3 is 3. 3 divided by 9 is 0.3333333. It goes on and on and on. So, of course, a person gets 27. Fits it all. Makes sense. Why, Father? Don't be all those more for me.
Driver said we'd be another few minutes.
Tempted to put your head outside the bus. Don't do it.
Why would I want to put my head outside the bus?
It's on that sign. Please keep head, arms, hands, and legs inside the bus at all times. It must be quite the problem if they had to make a sign. Hand, maybe I can see. Putting your hand down. It's quite refreshing, feeling the air rush along your outstretched palm. Like a bird on the end of your arm. But a leg? I couldn't do it even if I wanted to. And not that I would want to, I am just saying. So when you are tempted to squeeze that 8-inch skull through that 2-inch window, don't do it. I don't want anything happening to that lovely head. You know, when my mother named me Jezebel, she thought of it as a challenge. For your own good, she said. A crucible, she said. She used words like crucible. Had to pick Jezebel. Couldn't name me Eleanor, Cleopatra, or Malika, for God's sakes.
Who's Malika?
Malika. Oh, she was the first Buddhist queen, a queen of the Ganges. We Buddhists say Buddha instead of Buddha. And then smile and disdain at those who do. Oh, not in a superior way, of course. We don't believe in that. Buddha. Buddha.
When did she die?
Oh, thousands of years ago, I'm sure.
The queen, your mother, my, what, great-grand?
I meant her. Thousands of years ago. Before you were born. Before your mother was born. Sometimes I think before I was born. Though she was born a long, long time ago. Very distant woman, your great-grand.
Oh, it was all an intellectual experiment to her. And by it, of course, I mean me. Do you remember when you would go out to play and your mother would say, stay in the neighborhood and be home by 5? Your great-grand, she would just open the door and point. It's very disturbing at the time. But now, she could be like that again. Just walk out the door, no phone, no wallet.
We did that Thursday.
But for dying, she had been alive, the writer said, but you can't prove it by me.
She had brought himself poppy seed buns from the market.
But now she just slept and slept. You know, Chekhov.
Damn, he's funny.
Oh, yeah. Laugh a minute. He's like Tolstoy with a rubber chicken. How could he know so much about madness without being, you know, mad? Sometimes I'll sit down and, let's say, do a crossword. You know, think I'll do a crossword. Perfectly normal. Then I get to a word I don't know. And I try to think of it. And it's like all the barricades in my brain come crashing down. Everything that I have ever said or done, seen or thought, it floods into my brain all at once, and I can't stop it. I can't grab hold of anything. The dam bursts, and it washes me away. And I don't know where I am or what I was doing or who I'm supposed to be. It makes me feel like, I've lost myself. Time is up and it's all over. My life is over. A minute goes away. And the day ends. Another day begins. The sun comes up. I am sure I am going to live forever. I can't tell you how depressing that thought is.
Yeah. I just wanted to say, we're here, you know. Me and Mom, even if it's tomorrow or 100 years from now and you don't know where you are. We do, right? We can find the answer. And I'm sorry about those things I said outside. I hope you're okay. Are you okay?
Of course I'm okay. Everything is fine. Oh, compared to 5 minutes ago, I am sunshine on a cloudy day. Oh, lovely Rita. Don't ever be sorry. Your cute little dark, depressing outlook on everything. It's the only thing that keeps me going some days. The balance of the cosmos, don't you see? The darker you get, the lighter I have to be just to cancel it all out. If you woke up one day and realized that life is beautiful, or I lost a the tiny bit of very little brain I have left, and decided that the planet is just a swirling cesspool of the deepest black despair. You know, the Readiverse. Well, the Earth would just fall off its axis and spin out into the frozen void. Or it would plunge into the sun. Depends on which one of us is right.
Probably happen anyway, thanks to you people.
When did I get people?
I don't understand how you can go from free love to 401k in the same generation. The hell, when I was a baby, you used to play the Who and I get all rebellious and stuff. And now they're playing Hope I Die Before I Get Old in a yogurt commercial. What happened to you? And you're wrong. I think life is beautiful in my own way is all. I keep my eyes open is all. I don't get tricked by chubby babies or funny cat videos or the smell of cinnamon toast. Not that anyone has ever made me cinnamon toast, but I understand it is very seductive.
I don't know, dear. It's hard enough to explain myself. I can't be held responsible for an entire generation. Now take your mother. And I love your mother.
She's like a daughter to you.
Exactly. Right. But she's so damn serious. You know, she missed out on all the good DNA, the funny genes you and I have. Well, me. I don't know where she came from.
Cincinnati, originally. I think you said you were at a concert with that band Foghead when you gave birth.
Oh good, we're going. It should be just around the bend. And it was Hat Deer, Fog Hat, the band we were Foghead. I was very fond of the bass player. Just can't remember which one he was. And the name is Mary.
The bass player?
No, the blonde woman from Peter, Paul, and Mary. She was Mary. Well, it is in the name of the group, for God's sakes. Driver, slow down. Susan, driver, we're here. Tell the driver to slow down, Susan.
Oh, he's slowing down, Mother. Relax.
There it is, all right.
He has to slow down at the train tracks. He always slows down. Not a brain between them.
There's the house. Oh, and look, the hibiscus is in bloom. Oh, I remember when we planted that. Susan, you couldn't have been more than 4 or 5, just a tiny thing. And there it is, still blooming. And there you are. Well, you must have had a good blossom once, didn't you? And not the prize-winning flower we had hoped for, but still. Oh, Rita, look, a pool. A pool. They are building a pool, sweetheart. We never had a pool. Oh, I guess we never thought about it. What with your mother being so afraid of water and all.
I almost drowned.
Well, don't start that again. I mean, someone would have rescued you eventually. As a matter of fact, they did. So no harm done. Susan, Susie, Sue, love is the answer. All we need is love. As I said in the 60s, be here now.
Mother, I love to be here now. Fortunately, you're here now.
Well, there's my clever daughter again using my words against me.
Oh, your words. That's all I ever get is words. Sometimes I swear I'm the one who needs a rest home, but do I get a rest? No, then there they go. They act like they've never been on a bus before.
I know what you think about me. Oh, relax, you say. Like, I don't know what that means. You've been trying to get rid of me for ages.
Rest is for loonies. Not that I'm calling you loonies, Mother. It's just, I am just so overwhelmed by it all.
swear the minute I turn 21, I'm going to put both of them away and live on some deserted island. As long as it has a Starbucks. And Wi-Fi.
I'm watching you, Susie.
Oh, you may think I'm asleep, but there is always one eye open. This one. It is this one. Well, I forget which one, but one of them.
You think it's easy raising the Grim Reaper's niece?
Oh, funny, Grim Reaper's niece. At least that will be a stable family.
Poor Rita, what she must have to put up with.
Leave the head alone! If you want to go pet something, go get a monkey. I am not your monkey. Look at her. Your mother is alone. I knew that when I was 5 and she tucked the dog into my clothes and put him into my bed. Goodnight kiss was a little much, but she's not stupid. Sometimes she's the smartest person I know.
You two have this special bond. Me and her.
She and I.
Right there. That's exactly what she would say. And of course, it's right. Sorry. Correct. You've got just one full-time parent, and you'll never be perfect for her. It's like you're always running uphill, you know?
Mother, you do know to whom you're talking.
Do I do that? Me too. Well, friends in the family, I guess. Something you can pass on to your daughter.
As if.
Yeah, that's what I said. Since Daddy died, she says being alone doesn't matter, but I can see it does. She's fading away a little more every year. I certainly can't tell her to go out and find somebody, not with my track record. Two husbands divorced, one dead.
You forgot one.
Yes, Constantino. All he wanted was the green card. It seemed fair. I mean, I wasn't with anyone. And he was a fabulous dancer. Come and look at the house. At first, I thought it was fun. I could just ride by and just remember the good times and sort of stare out the other window when it got too real. But somewhere around year 10, I remembered that when I was a kid, I never liked that side of the street either. They were both the same. They were both scary. She wouldn't let me wear a helmet when I rode my bike. Said it would misshape my skull or something. You know what I did? I kept the training wheels on my bike until I was 14. They weren't actually touching the ground at that point, but I needed that safety net. I needed to feel like if I fell, something would catch me. So I never really learned how to ride a bike, and I now don't bother. She gave me my own set of keys. I was 4. Why did I need keys when I was 4? Where was I going by myself? Come and look at the house. Seems to cheer her up, doesn't it? I mean, I guess it's not so terrible, is it? Is it terrible? Sometimes I think it's terrible. I don't even like buses. Do you know that? Motion sickness. They say you outgrow it, but you never really do. Maybe I should buy one of those bracelets they give you when you take a cruise. The copper, and that always makes my wrist turn green.
Right there, me being quiet, let's ramble on like you know who. That's your Christmas present. When it comes to Christmas time, don't ask for anything. Trust me, you won't get it.
It's just that all of her memories are in that house. God knows she doesn't have much memory left. But I understand. It's unfair for me to ask you to give up your life, too. She's my mother.
Let's not get a lottery, okay? If you want one her about it.
You mean instead of you?
They go, Susan. You've been always telling me to open up about my feelings. Like, that's ever gonna happen. If you wanna talk about her, talk to her.
I tried that once. You ask her to open up about her feelings, and before you know it, she does. She won't shut up. So is there something that you want to talk about? Is there a boy?
There's no boy. Mm.
Because I'd be happy if there was a boy. Or a girl. Your grandmother already told me that you're having S-E-X.
What century is this? And you're okay with, how shall we put it, coupling with a person of an unspecified gender, and you actually spell out S-E-X.
I got a little uncomfortable after your tantrum out there. I didn't want to get you all riled up again.
There's no way. And damn her for telling you, yes, I've had S-E-X. I like S-E-X when I can find the right person, but there's nobody in S-E-X is not being had. And mother, I've heard you say sex before. You've been giving me the talk since I was 11.
I don't think very progressive.
Yeah. Real enlightened. Don't do this, don't do that, no touching below the neck, wear clean underwear, which doesn't make sense if we're not...
How do you do it like that?
The lights off, don't touch anything, don't put that in your mouth. And actually, I like putting that in my mouth.
You refuse to eat oysters. So, what's going on?
It's nothing, never mind.
Honey, tell me. Please. It's just you've been all rebellious and sulky lately, and that is so like a normal teenager that it frightens me. And is that a stun? Do you have a piercing? Let me see. Oh my God, Rita. There are laws against that kind of thing. Mother, we need to get to an emergency room immediately.
Yeah.
Oh.
It's fake. It's fake, damn it, and it took you 3 days to notice. No piercing, no tattoos. I practically pass out at the thought of a needle. You really think I'm gonna have a medical stab through my face? It's all a sham. I hate the thought of doling out my brain so drugs are out.
And your fear of needles, don't forget that.
My story! I have the talking stick. And if I came home pregnant, you'd paint my room pink, and Grandma ran out of rice paddy for the birth. Look at me. Goth, a 17-year-old goth antisocial. What kind of cliche am I? And on the very rare occasions where I find someone who I'd like to talk to, no, I won't last because they'll last to my family. And then you'll tell me to sit up straight while Graham wouldn't mind if I lay down all day so she can rub my freaking head. My mother is the predictably plain insecure normal, where my hippie grandma's on work release from an alternate universe. Section of reality is left for me. That's what I rebel against. Your mother fought with her mother. She fought with you. You fought with me. And my imaginary children with Michael Bublé will fight with me. It is built into our DNA. What the hell chance do any of us have?
Michael Bublé.
I'm a sucker for a crooner. Sue me.
Is orthopedics feet or children? Boy, that driver's cute. Sitting around all day hasn't hurt his butt. I should
take his picture.
Oh, maybe next month we'll bring a camera. We haven't taken a picture of the house in ages. Oh, another brilliant idea. Olive?
You know, Mother, I was thinking I might have something else to do next month. I don't know if I can.
Yeah, me too. School thing. The thing. First school.
Yes, a school thing. That darn thing, you know, kids and their things. Always have these things.
A thing? Things? Not go at all? Not go?
Oh, I don't think so. Not go. Well, honestly, it's the only time we ever do anything together anymore. And Susan, I know it was difficult, all of us living in that little house together, but, oh, I put up with you the best I could. We kept the family together. Now, that's the most important.
Oh, what is it? House.
Last place we were all together. Last place I saw your father happy.
I keep thinking one day we'll ride by and be working out in the yard.
Poisoning the flowers.
Cutting down the trees.
Overfeeding grass.
He was a regular death machine.
That's probably why he started riding the rails, no lawn.
Rails?
Grandpa, what's the word? Hobo?
Hobo.
Your grandfather was an independent spirit, sweetheart. He took to the road to find a real America, rid himself of attachments and expand his consciousness. Oh, it seemed very romantic at the time, so I said, oh, you go home, go along, darling. Oh, I don't know what I was thinking. He was gone for 5 years. Every Friday night, he had asked me if I wanted to go down to the boardwalk and buy an ice cream and walk on the beach. And I'd say, yes, if you would. And he'd just smile and say, that's okay, I just wanted to see if you would. Mm-hmm. He said we would retire one day and buy a condo in Las Vegas. I retire from what? I have no idea. He never did anything. And he hated gambling. Hated the desert. And the beach. And sand. He basically just, you know, hated that. Didn't even like glass all that much. Oh, that stuff. What's that stuff you rub on your feet? Pumice. Hated pumice so much you couldn't even say the word in his presence. So why he wanted to go to the boardwalk, I had no idea. But I thought it would make him happy, so I'd say yes. And he'd always say, I just wanted to see if you would. Sweet man. I think he was deranged.
Can we do that?
What's that, Rita?
That thing Grandpa wanted to do?
Go to Las Vegas? Hit the road. We'll do it. I'll teach you how to be groupies. Oh, we will follow that nice young man around the country. You know, the one with the hair. Oh, can either of you drive? I took away my license a long time
ago. Not Vegas. Get ice cream. Walk on the beach. Go to the boardwalk. Get an ice cream and walk on the beach. Get on the bus driving the other way. The bus that goes to the beach. Take the bus to the beach. Take
the bus to the beach and look out at the water. Look at the horizon. Look ahead instead of back here. Look ahead. Next Sunday, an extra trip. Together. Can we do that? Can we take the bus to the beach next Sunday and see something that hasn't already happened every bus trip, every moment for our entire lives? Can we? Can we take the bus to the beach? Can we start over? We'll see, dear. It all depends on your grandmother.
Yes, if you'd like to. Yes, we can. We'll hit the road, go to the beach. Whatever you two want is a-okay by me. You know, honestly, you would think I was the most difficult person in the world to get along with. Back in the 60s? Oh, it must have been 67, 68 maybe. I went to the beach with that famous British hair model, Robert Plant. Well, he was going to the beach and I was following him. But stalking is such an unpleasant word. Anyway.
Not Vegas. Get ice cream and walk on the beach. Go to the boardwalk and get an ice cream and walk on the beach. Get on the bus going the other way. Look ahead next Sunday, an extra trip together. Can we do that? Can we go next Sunday?